Celebrating quite the milestone, the last member of an elite group of TSA agents is retiring.
The group brought in a new level of security to the airport, and it's got a furry angle here. The Kobe feeling is here, showing us how they thanked her, and he's in studio with this story. Kobe, her career wasn't even that long.
No, only 9 years, and you may be asking yourself, who could garner such a reputation in such a short career? You probably haven't met Lenore. She was among the very first 8 passenger screening K-9s in the nation. She's the only and last one in the litter, to retire. So TSA started training and raising these dogs almost a decade ago down at Lackland Air Force Base. Lenore and her siblings were sent to Indy and to Oklahoma City. That was starting in 2012. Lenore was so good, Lackland wanted to keep her as an example of what canines can do because she's demonstrated for members of Congress and at airports across the nation. As the first airport to introduce the program, Indy says she set the standard. She sniffed millions of passengers, fans at 4 Super Bowls and 1 MLB All-Star game. Needless to say, many members of the TSA are sad to see her go.
It's bittersweet. I'm excited that she's going to go ahead and retire and be able to enjoy life, but it's going to be sad leaving her home all the time.
TSA says passengers are excited to see the dogs themselves because it means they don't have to take off their shoes and remove their laptops. While Lenore never actually found a bomb, she is so good that she sniffed out singular chemicals that could be used in the making of a bomb one time all the way across the terminal, like 250 yards away. TSA, like bomb-sniffing dogs, were introduced as a way to ramp up security after 9/11. And each one of those puppies trained at Lackland, they're named after the victims to honor their memory and remind TSA of the program's purpose. Frank?
Yeah, we need their help and appreciate the service. 624. So we told you Hamilton's coming to Indianapolis.